always there. And even though I try to sleep through him, I can't because I know he's there waiting. So we're not even friends. But anyway, all of us in this country are sitting here with an opportunity to change the economy of the country. And it's all on the back of cheap energy. Now that happened in the Industrial Revolution and decades ago, and now you're getting the same opportunity again. Now it's, at this point, it's got a missing part to it, and that is Washington leadership. Does that surprise you? An energy discussion in Washington cannot go longer than 5 minutes because they run out of something to talk about. They really do not understand what is right here offered to us in this country. They don't see it. They're caught up. The last thing those guys think of, women too, I know they've got women congressmen too. My daughter, one time, seriously thought about running for governor of Texas. It was in 1990. And my daughter had worked for Governor Clemens, and she came on board with me and gave me a lot of advice, a lot more than I wanted. Anyway, she told me to quit calling women girls. She said, call women women. You call men men, you don't call them boys. Made sense to me. So that was when she was 20. I didn't run for governor. When she was 30, she said, you remember one time I gave you some advice about don't call women girls? And I said, yes, I do. I took it. She said, well, go back to girls because we would rather be called girls than women. A lot happened in 10 years. Anyway, we're here with an opportunity. That's what I want to talk about. And the opportunity presents itself because we have never had an energy plan in America. Never. We're the only country in the world without an energy plan. I can take you back to 1970, and Richard Nixon said, at the end of this decade, we will not import any oil. When he made the statement, we imported 24%. At the end of the decade, we imported 28%. He did nothing. He had no plan.